all that and lots more too. Four number ones though, first in a year, and the youngest male to go in at number one. Gareth Gates was a true pop phenomenon, breaking records and topping the charts as soon as he was off the Pop Idol leash. And you've got to make it big to front a Comic Relief record. Remember this? Oh, set me up with
to the beautiful boy who could sing but couldn't speak. Well, he's here to tell us. We welcome you, Gareth. It's lovely to see you.
It's lovely to be back. Thank you.
We saw the documentary over, I think it was Christmas, wasn't it?
Yes, yes.
And Whatever Happened to Gareth Gates. Mm. And in that, we learnt how you've been getting your voice sorted out, helping other people, coaching people for their stammers as well.
Yeah.
And everything fixed. You're good now.
I mean, I'm part of a speech therapy programme called the Maguire Programme. And, yeah, for the past 3 years, one of the things I've been working on is working on my speech, but also giving something back, which is a real sort of rewarding, fulfilling feeling to be able to teach others how to speak.
Yeah, you really do teach others. You take your own course of people and you...
I mean, you know, I never thought that I'd be able to speak, let alone sort of help others. And, yeah, it's, you know, it's such a great feeling to be able to do that.
Well, I hope you don't mind me saying, because the last time you came in,
yes,
when we interviewed you, there was a whole regimen that went with the interview. We sat down before the programme started. We all did vocal exercises together. We did all that sort of stuff, which for you is a hell of a lot of baggage to drag in as a pop artist selling a single.
Sure.
You know, sitting the presenters down and having to go through all that sort of thing, which of course we were happy to do. But for you, not having to do that sort of thing, walking in, saying, good morning, everyone, how are you, must be amazing.
No, it really is. I mean, being part of the programme, there are sort of certain techniques you need to use for a certain while, and you have to be very disciplined, certainly in the early stages. Eventually, you do achieve a bit more fluency, and you know, you can start to relax, start to enjoy you know, the freedom of speaking a lot
and
more.
And chatting with your mates.
Yeah,
something that you couldn't do.
Yeah, I mean, you know what it's like when you're in a pub round the table. It's all about banter. It's all about the wittiest person. And, in the past, I always had the witty thoughts but could never get them out. And so I am the funniest guy now out of all my mates, which is
of
good.
Of course.
But they're all saying, oh, for God's sake, shut him up.
Exactly.
So this is a hackneyed question, but where have you been? We know you've been doing that, but what happened to Gareth Gates, pop star?
Yeah, well, I think in the early days everything happened so fast that I never really had the opportunity to let it sink in, to reflect on what had happened. So, and I think I needed a bit of a break just to get a bit of headspace and things, which was great. Then I started to work on my new record. I wasn't really sure what sort of music I wanted to make, and so it was very much an experimental period for me, working with different writers from all around the world, in search of a new sound, a new direction.
Is this the new album that's called Pictures on the Other Side?
Yes.
Why is it Pictures on the Other Side?
Pictures of the Other Side.
Of the Other Side. Sorry.
No worries. That's one of the tracks on the album. You can buy the album and see.
Okay, well, the album's out soon, but the single from it, Changes.
Yeah, Changes, that's the first single. Changes for me pretty much sums up the past 3 years, in that a lot has changed, and it talks about relationships and the people that you surround yourself with having an influence on you. It's out this week.
Shall we have a look?
Shall we?
Yeah,
okay,
let's.
Here you go. It was a sort of a forced change of style for you anyway, wasn't it? Because of the being dropped by the record company. Mm. And that, at the time, although thank goodness it's all worked out well in the end, but at the time you must have thought, you know, the bottom's fallen right out of my world now.
Yeah, I mean, I was a bit gutted, you know, I'm not going to lie there. And, you know, but it's funny how life works. I've signed a new big deal with Universal, and I think, you know, getting out of that format has really sort of given me the creative freedom just to do what I want, you know, to write the songs that I want to write, and get a lot more involved in that, a lot more involved in the recording side of things, which is something that, you know, if I'd have stayed with my last label, I think it would have been quite hard for them to just give me that freedom all of a sudden, which was, you know, which is a real sort of great feeling to be able to do.
How old are you now, Gareth?
22.
22. Yeah. You started at 17.
Yeah.
The youngest person ever to have four number ones in 12 months. Mm. 12 months since somebody like Frank Ifield or something. A long time.
Yeah.
And when you were 17, I'm trying to do the maths. 5 years then, isn't it? Gosh,
yes.
5 years since we all were up on that Saturday night, dialing madly and voting for both of you. In fact, I did vote for both of you. I couldn't decide. Do you remember that?
That sort of rubs it out, though, doesn't it?
It did, but I couldn't. I couldn't. I was so invested so much in you and Will, in, you know, likability and everything. You vote for both guys, which is a bit silly at the time, but there we are, I did. So in 5 years, your learning of life and your experience of the business is what somebody else would have learned over perhaps 30 years. And you've got to learn from that and use it positively.
Yeah. I mean, it certainly did feel like that, you know. I think, well, you guys know as well, you know, being in the sort of business, it does really speed up your life in, you know, this all sort of learning process, learning about trust, learning about just things like finance and, you know, things that you'd never even have to think about when you're
public
17.
Relationships.
Yeah, public, exactly.
True friends.
Yeah, true friends.
Do you see anything of Will or any of the Pop Idol lot?
Yeah, myself and Will often text each other. We meet up for a beer every now and then.
That's nice.
You know, he's really doing well. He was up in Manchester for the past 3 months. I think he's involved in a play up there.
How much more work do you have to do with your speech now? Do you have to think about the way you approach a conversation?
Yeah. Well, one of the things about the Maguire programme, and something that I've, if I'm honest with you, over the past couple of weeks, I've struggled with a bit. You sort of read the headlines of, you know, Gareth Gates' stammer's gone. You know, the Maguire programme isn't a cure, it's something that you just need to maintain, and you need to do your exercises sort of every day, breathing, warm-ups, etc. And so, you know, that sort of added more pressure because, you know, finally everyone knows that I'm able to handle interviews, so people think that the stammer's completely gone. I'm sure in the future you'll see me have little slip-ups and, you know, I just want to make that clear before people go, oh, you know, he's gone backwards. Or
but no, time will let you relax into it. And
sure.
As we all make mistakes, they get, it doesn't matter in the end.
No, that's right.
No, you just can't get lazy, though, can you?
No, well, yeah, exactly. No, I mean, it does get easier. The amount of exercises and warm-ups I do now is a lot less than back in the early day. I mean, there's always a something quite scary about it, just because you get complacent. Mm. You know, that's when you start to see, you know, things going a bit wrong. But it's the same with everything.
Well, it's a remarkable change, regardless of you know how worried you might be inside. It's fantastic to finally get to talk to you.
Oh yeah, thank you
and welcome back.
It's lovely to see you. So good luck with the single
thank
Changes, which is out right now.
It is.
Thank you. Lovely
thank
to
you.
See
thank
Gareth.
You.
How about a bit of a